Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy, and today I'm talking about formulas. This is an introduction to that topic. Formulas are an equation that contain more than one variable. So you are familiar with equations, but we've had one variable in our equations. Once we have two, we can call it a formula. Some common formulas that you may remember is A equals L times W, that's the area of a rectangle. P equals 2L plus 2W, that's the perimeter of a rectangle. And D equals R times T, which is distance equals rate times time. And I think actually in that formula it's usually a lowercase d, and those matter. Just to throw capitals and lowercase in there is a little annoying, and I just did it. Okay, so this one, in the first case, we're just taking a formula and we're substituting a value into it. So we have area equals 1/2 base times height. That's the formula for a triangle. And so we're saying, what is A if B equals 10 and H equals 4? And this is just a substitution problem, right? So we would say, well, what is A if we have 1/2 and then base is 10 and height is 4? So we just replaced the B and the H with what we were given. And then we simplify to find out what A is. 10 times 4 is 40, and half of that would be 20. So I could say A is 20 if B was 10 and H is 4. But in a little more complicated vein, this one says, same formula, what is B if A is 100 and H is 40? So now I was given A. So I'm going to come over here. I was given A to be 100. I still have the 1/2. I don't know B, but I do know that H is 40. So whatever you're given, you substitute in, and then you solve that formula for B to find out what that is. Well, even though half is here and 40 is there, because of the commutative property, I could change the order. So I'm going to think about just doing that in my head and saying, what is half of 40? And that's 20. And now how would I solve for B? Well, all I have to do is get rid of that coefficient. And you do that by dividing both sides by 20. And you get B is 5. So we plugged in the values that we knew, and we solved or substituted and then simplified that to find out what that one value was that we didn't know. All right, the next one, W equals 2x plus 2k. I don't know what that is. I just made that up. I could have looked a little deeper and gotten a real formula for you. What is k? We don't know that one. If we know W is 20, as always, great practice to pause and try this on your own. X is 4, and we don't know what K is. That's the one that we can't simplify for. Well, I know that 2 times 4 is 8. How do I solve this problem? Well, we've been doing problems like that for a while now. If we want to get K by itself, we get rid of the 8 by using the addition property of equality. 20 minus 8 is 12. The 8s are additive inverses. They're gone. And I have 2K left. And again, I don't want a coefficient of 2. I just want one single K. So I divide by the coefficient, and that gives me K. I know that K is 6. So given those values, I can figure out the missing piece. And one last one, a little bit more complicated looking. This is actually the formula for the area of a, It's this. You know, I have trouble remembering my words, but that's the symbol. It'll come to me. Okay. If I know that A is 90, and I have 1/2, and I don't know H, I know that the big B or the large base is 10 and the small base is 5. Okay, now I want to solve that by adding my two bases together, simplifying inside the parentheses. I'm going to move that over there. 10 plus 5 is 15. And then I'm going to put the 1 half times 15. I'm not going to make that a decimal. I'm just going to call it 15 halves h. This has got a little tricky fraction in there, but overall, not that hard. And then I want to get rid of that. You have two choices. I'm going to show you both choices because it's been a little while since we've done something like this. One is you just go ahead and divide both sides by 15 halves. Okay? And let's see how you could do that on your calculator. Still haven't thought of the name of that. It's a very common shape that you guys are probably cringing that it hasn't popped into my head. I keep wanting to say tangrams, which is not it. Okay, 90 divided by, and remember this fraction button right here. We're dividing by a fraction, so I'm going to divide by 15 fraction halves. Okay, so now it's 90 divided by 15 halves, and that is 12. Perfectly legitimate way to do that, and it's a great use of your calculator. Okay, then the other way, if you got to this point and you wanted to solve, you want to make the coefficient of h be positive 1. 2 fifteenths multiply 2 fifteenths. What happens over here is all these cancel, leaving h. And over here, we know that 2 fifteenths times 90, well, we could cross cancel and do that without the calculator, or we could do it with the calculator. That is 2 fraction 15 times 90. And again, we get 12. So either way, you get the same answer as you're trying to plug in the two values, or in this case, the three values that we know, to solve for that fourth unknown value. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you.